Hi everyone. Today I want to introduce about Half-Heusler intermetallic compound for thermoelectric application. So here is a brief outline of my presentation. First, I'm going to talk about the definition of thermoelectricity and which compounds are used for thermoelectric materials. And then I will illustrate the concept and theory of electric effect and important parameter to evaluate the efficiency. Next, I'm gonna introduce two methods of enhancing thermoelectric performance. And in the end, I will show you some applications and discuss the main drawback and prospect of thermoelectric materials. So let's start. Thermoelectricity is a word combined with two forms of energy, which are heat and electricity. The electric effect is the direct conversion of temperature differences to electric voltage and vice versa. So in other words, thermoelectric device converts either heat to electricity or electricity to heat by the situation. So it is one of reversible process. Motivation for researching thermoelectric materials is to save Earth by reusing the waste energy. Also, there is limited amount of fossil fuels. So thermoelectric materials have advantage of protecting Earth, and there is infinite energy, for example, solar energy. I want to introduce which materials are used in thermoelectrics and electric materials and how much efficiency we can observe of these materials. So on y-axis, the ZT is called figure of merits, and it is important parameter that helps to determine the efficiency of thermoelectric devices. I will elaborate it deeply soon. So diverse compounds are used as thermoelectric materials, for example, indium antimony or some chalcogenides like bismuth tellurides, and also tin solutes. Selenium are also used. But today, I'm going to focus on Half-Heusler intermetallic compound. Half-Heusler compound is represented as ABX, where A and B are transition metals or noble metals. And X is metal in main group element. So for your information, full Heusler material contain all four interpenetrating sublattice, whereas Half-Heusler compound consists of three field interpenetrating FCC sublattice and one vacant FCC sublattice. So let's go on to second part. There are two representative thermoelectric effects, which are Zebec effect and Peltier effect. Zebec effect was discovered by German physicist Thomas Zebec. And Zebec effect is that thermal gradient across a sample results in voltage gradient. So the absolute value of average velocity of charge carriers is higher in the warm end. Therefore, the effective diffusion towards from warm end to the cold end. And the Peltier effect is exactly reverse of the Zebec effect, which is creating a heat difference from an electric voltage or current. So if you flow the current, the one side is cooled and the other side rejects heat. In this slide, I want to elaborate material parameters of thermoelectric materials. So figure of merit, denoted by ZT, is the primary parameter of the thermoelectric potential of a material. It is dimensionless, and it is expressed mainly by three parameters, which are Zebec coefficient, electrical conductivity, and thermal conductivity. And the thermal conductivity is composed of electronic thermal conductivity and lattice thermal conductivity. The exact equation is written here. And why this value is so important? Because the reason is that it is related to conversion efficiency. So if we have high value of ZT, then we have higher conversion efficiency. Also, it is proved that the larger temperature difference makes the higher efficiency. So to get the higher efficiency, high ZT value is required. Then which materials have high ZT value? This is comparison of three big different materials group, which are insulators, semiconductors, and metals. We can see the tendency of each parameter on the left-hand side. So for example, higher value of Zebec coefficient in insulator, whereas higher electrical conductivity in metal. So after calculating these values, we can recognize that semiconductor has the highest ZT value. We should keep in mind that it is very difficult to satisfy high ZT value because these three physical properties are interdependent. In other words, a modification to any of these properties often adversely affects the other properties. So let's move on to the third part. There are many reasons that we are using Half-Heusler compounds for thermoelectric materials. Half-Heusler compound is one of the best non-intermetallic compounds, and the intermetallic compound has advantage of narrow band gap, high effective mass, mechanical robustness, and work in high temperature with high thermal stability. So Half-Heusler compounds works around 600 Kelvin to 1000 Kelvin. So fundamentally, Half-Heusler compounds have narrow band gap rather than other materials because it is intermetallic compound, and abundant elements can be used in each atom. And also, due to the specific structural features, it can be easily modified. So to get high ZT value, we can lower the lattice thermal conductivity by substituting to heavier atoms, for example, titanium to zirconium or hafnium. And also, to increase in electrical conductivity, atoms are easily substituted which have more valence electrons. So for example, tin can be substituted to antimony, and titanium can substitute it to tantalum. So the first method to improve thermoelectric performance is doping. Via doping, we can tune the carrier concentration. It is possible to dope each of three occupied FCC sublattice individually due to specific structural feature. As carrier concentration increases, electrical conductivity increases, then power factor and ZT value increase accordingly. And doping in Half-Heusler compounds also introduce point defects, mass fluctuation scattering, and strain field effects that can be utilized in order to effectively scatter short and mid-wavelength heat-carrying phonons. So by reducing thermal conductivity value and increasing power factor, we can have high, significantly high ZT value. And from now on, I want to introduce second method of enhancing thermoelectric performance. First example is microscale Half-Heusler matrix with nano inclusions. So zirconium nickel tin was used as Half-Heusler matrix, and zirconium dioxide was used as nano inclusions. So this is 20 nanometer nanoparticles of zirconium dioxide captured by transmission electron microscopy. So the nanocomposite was made by mechanical mixing, and the purpose of sintering nano inclusion is to scatter heat carrying phonons and subsequently reduce the resulting lattice thermal conductivity. As it observed in the graph, the lattice thermal conductivity was reduced by 35% as compared with the original Half-Heusler compound, because particles are distributed at the grain boundary, so it behaves as phonon scattering centers in order to scatter the heat carrying phonons. Therefore, the phonon mean free path is reduced. So accordingly, the lattice thermal conductivity reduced. However, due to scattering of electrons, electrical resistivity has increased. Even though decrease of electrical conductivity, the value of ZT increased by 15% at 900 Kelvin. Second example is nanoscale Half-Heusler matrix with nano inclusions. The sample was prepared by ball milling and hot pressing. The small grains, precipitates, and lattice distortions are desirable for low thermal conductivity due to a possible increase in phonon scattering. In figure C, some precipitates in the matrix are observed, and in figure D shows discontinuous distorted crystal lattice. And those contribute to lower kappa. However, electrical conductivity of nanocomposite is significantly lower than ingot material at room temperature, because small grain and lattice distortions also scatter the charge carriers and influence to lowering electron mobility. To overcome this problem, the appropriate grain size of Half-Heusler matrix was studied, and the best performance was showed around 200 nanometer, because if the size is smaller than 200 nanometer, the scattering of electrons will be dominant due to the reduced mobility of electron. To recap, the enhancement of ZT value of Half-Heusler compounds is shown by this graph, and by doping, charge carrier concentration increases and it makes higher electrical conductivity. And by nanostructuring, we can reduce the thermal conductivity by boundary scattering effect. So the kappa value is in denominator and sigma value is in numerator. So as the value of numerator increased and the value of denominator decreased, we can get high ZT value. Let's look more application in industry. Thermoelectric materials is mainly used in power generation and refrigeration. The most promising application is thermoelectric power generation based on Seebeck effect. So by temperature difference, it creates electric motive force. So as you can see in this small video clip, by heating up the surface, the motor is rotating. Also, thermoelectric coolers uses the Peltier effect to create a heat flux by flowing current. So by giving current, this water transferred into the ice. There are many advantages of thermoelectric power generation. It is silent, no mechanical or chemical process, robust, and durable with high reliability. Currently, thermoelectric materials can be widely used in solar thermoelectric converters to transfer solar energy to electricity. Also, it is used in automobile, and BMW starts the project of thermoelectric generator. The aim of the project is to improve overall engine efficiency by generating electric current from waste heat. So it will also contribute to considerable fuel savings. Thermoelectric materials are also frequently used in refrigeration and air cooling. Peltier coolers are often used in air cooling, and nowadays, many people are buying a Peltier cooler kit to cool down the CPU fans of computer. And also, cool drinks for the picnic is possible by thermoelectric coolers. And now, we are going to discuss the main drawback and assignment of thermoelectric materials. Even though there are many advantages of thermoelectric materials, the main drawback of thermoelectric materials is low energy conversion efficiency, which is around 5 to 6%. To improve efficiency, we need higher ZT materials. We can either modify the structure of existing materials or find a new material. My topic for today belongs to the former case. Kappa can be lowered by complex structure and heavy atoms due to phonon scattering. And electrical conductivity can be improved by doping. And Seebeck coefficient can be increased by large density of state at Fermi energy by substituting the two large effective mass atom and low dimensional system. But you should keep in mind that it is very, very difficult to improve all of three variables at once because these three parameters are interdependent. In case of finding a new material, basic requirements should be satisfied. For example, low cost, environment friendly, earth abundant elements, and non-toxic, and more. Discovering the high ZT values of new materials under these conditions is also crucial. Thermoelectric field has been researched very short time, so it has huge potential to develop. Before finishing the presentation, my last sentence would be, it is important to note that waste heat is 0% efficiency process, and thus any cost-effective technology that can recover some part of the waste heat is very important. Thanks for your attention.